Hello, my name is Walter, and welcome back to Walter Reacts. And I just started this series, actually. I watched episode 1 on my own, just to see whether or not this was a good show to react to. And I still kind of think it is. I'm going to give you my thoughts briefly on the past episode first, before we jump into this episode. I know that, you know, it's always important to see me react to episode 1, so if you still want me to react to episode 1, I will do that. So just suggest it in comments if you want. So in the last episode, the series I'm doing is, of course, the series of unfortunate events based on the novel A Series of Unfortunate Events by Lemony Snicket. And I did grow up reading the book. I had to. My three sisters had the book, so I had to read it too. And I actually liked the movie. I know some people didn't really like it. I don't know why. But I don't know why. I think I prefer Jim Carrey's Count Olaf, and I think I will be talking about that during this episode. So without further ado, let's go. The series seems to be more of the series theme song seems to be more of comedic thing, and I really think that they are doing more of it as a comedy, because there are few moments where it's supposed to be, I think it's supposed to be funny. I think they're definitely going for the more comedic side of the things, because I feel like Jim Carrey, while doing a little bit of comedy as well, really captured the creepiness for me. Two of the big names here I'm noticing is Bonnie Sonnenfeld and Bo Welch. So that's really interesting for me, because Bo Welch is a good production designer. And here we have Mr. Poe. For some reason, I imagined Mr. Poe as a big, round, not really fat, but like roundish, big round guy with a top hat and everything. But this rendition seems to be alright. I think in the movie as well, it is something more to the book a little bit. And yeah, it's Patrick Warburton doing the narrating. At all of the first episode, I was thinking, like, why is it I'm listening to Kronk from The Emperor's New Groove? Oh, and the ending of the first episode, we saw Will Arnett and Kobe Smulders, the mother and father, which I was like, Mr. Will Arnett, when are you making the new BoJack Horseman? Because we all are waiting for the new BoJack Horseman, because the last episode did leave us on a real cliffhanger. Yeah, they did. Yikes. Well, I mean, they still have an inheritance, which Count Olaf is after. But I do like the house set where the props and everything really captures the creep value, but it's just it's maybe sometimes Neil's performance there doesn't really match that, and he tries, by God, he tries. Like the makeup is good, but I think it just doesn't match. But I don't know, that's just me though. I still have really a really soft spot for Jim Carrey's portrayal of Count Olaf, and I think I always will, because I grew up with that movie as well. Will you please do the premises? Yeah, so the makeup is really good. I really like how they did the hair and everything. And it's a slight variation of the Jim Carrey's one. And yes, like the series is, the episodes are long, but it doesn't feel long, like. What? Does the finger waving thing. What is she doing? Oh. Sorry. It's annoying. Like that mole, like that fake mole. What happened to Jacqueline? That's true. It is. Did you? Look at mine. Yeah, I knew he was gonna say that. Ugh. The blowing wind on the outside. Yeah, right. Really standoffish? No, it doesn't really. Or, you know, somebody kind of brags about it, but, you know, doesn't get in your face about it. Oh. She has good skills. Oh, hello. He tried to marry her. Right. I remember. Wait, what is the legal marrying age though in this world? sorry, Violet. Okay, this is really weird though. I never noticed until now, like when I've grown up. GG. It's a lot of pedophilia. There's a lot of pedophilia themes in this story. Oh. No, go talk to the woman in the wig. I can't stand looking at you anymore. With a mouthful of muffins. Rupia float. Agreed to being the back half of a horse. Okay. GG. Set life. She's inside the What research? Critique? Oh, that's really old school though. I mean, theater is all about old schoolness, so that's not really weird, but. It's true. Chinese cars, hey, let's not go there. Really? Name one. Fall off? GG. Why that shot though? Like just hanging. Nuclear. No. What is he talking about, man? No, bro, it's all a cold, calculated plan. Oof, bro, it's not an act. Ew, what the fuck? What the fuck? Justice Strauss's dreams come true. Yeah, fracking right. Gigi. Seize the children. Seize the day, city. Oh my. And say your prayers. I don't know this guy's story though. The guy with the hook hands. Literally is in literal, yeah, in reality, imaginative, right? Literally. Right. Sure. The money. That's true. Latin. she has enthusiasm. It's a little bit of Jim Carrey's impression there. A little bit of a Joker in there. I hope you're not talking about you, bro. Yes, it would. Ew. What have you done? She's still strapped to the. could you cut these ropes for me? Yeah, I think that'd be good, bro. I think that's one of the things that is recurring in the book as well, like just a reflection of like what the other people say into their lives as well, is to show like a recurring cycle, man. Of course it isn't. I forget what she makes though. Brings a baby breath in Violet's hair. Bruh, physics is not on your side. You have to throw upwards and in an angle. No, you can't do that. No. You can't do that. You can't keep throwing it upwards because the wind resistance, it's all against you. But sure. Gamble on luck. Why not? Fuck physics. Wow. That's highly implausible, but okay. Well, I mean, if she really did do the electronics and all the other stuff, maybe. How are you gonna tell? Oh, hello. Kick him out the window. Oh, very soon you will be GG hench person in law. Yeah, it must be. Bad touch, bruv. Fuck's sake. Ah, to be young and blissful. Seriously. The nuptial law. Yeah, that's true. Cowdo love. Beatrice? Ah, that's nice. Oh, I love this sub. I love the sets. That's true. Hello, good to see you again. Yeah, right. I understand how the siblings understand, but like, how do the other people understand the baby? Just seeing your selfish desires about being an actor when you were younger. Don't distract me with aisle cheddar. Why is she mimicking him? Hey. It's the same theorist that says when they showed the definition of literally and figuratively. With her tight hands. Such fake CGI hands, man. Oh, that's not good, man. Checks 287. Oh, that's a flush. That's a flush right there. Figuratively. What was the plot, dude? If it does not coincide with the plot, like, it's just weird. Isn't the plot kind of like the reincarnations of Count Olaf having many suitors? Kind of like? She has a bit of stage fright. Woman, man. I do. Tear the paper. Hopefully, Sunny is not that good. Not that unsafe. I was about to say not that guarded. Yeah, that's weird. Literally. Terrible person. Charles Fu. Tied up at the moment. Oh. GG. I'm the judge. Well, all legal documents need to be in the hand that. What? Convincing. What? How did it go from how did it jump from signing a document in your left hand and going into morality? Technically, it doesn't count, right? Doubt that. Wait, it should be limb from limb. She looks really hurt by that. Your dreams of being an actress put us in grave danger, but your heart was in the right place. Uh-oh. Oh no. I have a feeling like Jacqueline and Gustave is really close to the parents of the Baudelaires, so that's something that always comes to my mind. She really wanted to adopt them. It's all law, bro. Oh, secret organizations. It's that insignia. All right, that's really good. That was really good though. So yeah, guys, that was about it. So yeah. yeah, it's a bit long, and so I won't really do a post reaction kind of thing. So thanks a lot, and I will see you in the next video.